timber company like Rainier, we need to know how many trees we have or how much volume of wood we have, and then also in what product classes that wood is in. And so we do what we call a timber cruise, which is getting an inventory just like you would if this were a factory and you need to go out and see how many widgets are in your factory. We need to see how much wood is out there in our stands. My name is Rusty Cobb. I'm the Timber Marketing Manager for the Southern Zone of the Coastal Resource Unit. I'm based here in Yulee, Florida, and today we're in Nassau Forest, and we're going to talk about inventories. We can't measure every single tree. That's just not possible, and would be way too costly even if we could do it. So we take a statistical sample in a cruise, and so we go out into the woods and we set up a plot, and then we'll measure trees on that plot, collect the data and bring that back, and then run that through some analysis software that gives us an idea or a good estimate for how much volume of wood is out there in a particular stand. Inventories are used for multiple reasons. One reason is for our growth and yield projections. In other words, if we measure the stand when it's relatively young, our LIS department will take that data and they will apply growth and yield models. And so in the future, they don't have to remeasure that stand unless it has drastically changed through some sort of harvesting from thinning or what have you. But if it hasn't really changed for the next few years, they don't need to remeasure it. So they will apply growth and yield models that will tell us how much wood is out there at a given point in the future. And we do that for harvest scheduling. And then also, we do what we call harvest cruising. And that's where we go out and we cruise and we get an inventory, and we that way we know real accurately what to expect for pricing, because we apply value to that volume that's out there. And that's how we budget each year based on those harvest cruises. When a forester reaches their plot center, they will use their prism and they will swing around. They will hold the prism over the plot center. You'll usually have a plot staff to mark the center, and they will count every tree that is quote unquote in. It lines up, the picture lines up, the top and the bottom of the tree lines up with what they see in the prism. And for every tree that they count in, they will go then and they will measure the diameter and the height on those trees. And they will tally those into their data recorder, and then when they're done with that for the plot, then they will move to the next plot. One of the main measurements that we take in any inventory is called DBH, or diameter breast height. And breast height being 4.5 feet above the ground is where the tree is measured. And we have usually specialized tape, measuring tape, that actually measures the diameter. It's calibrated to measure diameter and not circumference. But this tape will go around that, and it's calibrated, and then you can read that measurement, and that gives you the actual diameter across the stem. If you were to cut it at 4.5 feet, it will give you that diameter. And that cross-sectional area, if you were to cut a stem at 4.5 feet, that's called the basal area of that particular tree. This is a clinometer. This is our basic tool for measuring heights on trees. If you stand back at a specified distance and you look up at the top of the tree, and you get the tip top lined up with the little ocular gauge in here, it will tell you what the height of the tree is. That's the basics of how a variable radius plot is done. Now that we've collected our data in the field for the day, we'll upload this into our office computer, and then we will generate the numbers that we need to know exactly how much wood is out here and the approximate value of that. And that is very useful for our budgeting, forecasting, also our timber sales program.